Hello kids, I'm Dr. Harshad Bhanushali. Today we'll learn a simple method on identifying the various pedigree charts. You know that in the chapter Principles of Inheritance, you have pedigree charts which are given, and generally multiple choice questions are asked on identification of the pedigree chart. What I'll do is I'll give you a simple method by which you can easily identify the pedigree charts. First, what we'll do is we'll familiarize with the common symbols which are used in these charts. You already know that it's already done in these chapters. This is a symbol for a normal male. If it is shaded, then it becomes an affected male. A circle is a symbol of a normal female. If shaded, it becomes an affected female. This symbol, of course, it's not in your NCERT, is a symbol of a female who's suffering from, who's is actually a carrier of a particular trait. So these are the symbols which are commonly used in these pedigree charts. And now basically these are the three different types of pedigree charts which can be asked in your MCQs. Now, how do you identify them? So there are basically two steps to this identification process. The first is we identify whether it is an autosomal disorder or whether it is a sex chromosomal disorder. Now, how do you identify this? How do you differentiate whether the pedigree chart is of an autosomal disorder or whether the pedigree chart is a sex chromosomal disorder? A simple method. If it is a sex chromosomal disorder, you would find a pattern of inheritance. This, if you see, is the pedigree chart of color blindness. This is a pedigree chart of color blindness. Now, if you observe here, the inheritance is showing a pattern. What do I mean by that? Here, the male is suffering from color blindness. In the next generation, there is no one suffering from color blindness, but the females are the carriers. In the next generation, again, the male is suffering from color blindness. If you see the inheritance, it skips a generation. So you had a grandfather and the grandson suffering from color blindness. You know, there is a line about a color blindness disorder. There is a line about sex chromosomal disorders, that they go from the grandfather to the grandson through the carrier female. They go from the grandfather to the grandson through the carrier female. You call it as the crisscross inheritance. So that's my point. If you observe in the pedigree chart, crisscross inheritance. If you observe in the pedigree charts, males being more as the sufferers of the disorders. If you see females, generally carriers. So if you see males, more males affected, if you see females, generally carriers, and if you see crisscross inheritance, it's a sex chromosomal disorder. So that is our first step, that when you have a pedigree chart in front of you, how do you identify whether it is an autosomal disorder, whether it is a sex chromosomal disorder? So the tip is, if you don't see a pattern, if you don't see such pattern, that means it is an autosomal disorder. If you see a pattern, what pattern? Crisscross inheritance. Grandfather, grandson. Grandfather suffering, grandson suffering through the carrier female. If you see this crisscross pattern, it's a sex chromosomal disorder. That's your first step. Okay, so you have identified that whether it is a sex chromosomal disorder or whether it is an autosomal disorder. Our next step would be, if it is an autosomal disorder, the options may have two options, whether it is an autosomal dominant or whether it is an autosomal recessive disorder. So for that, a very simple trick. How do you identify whether it is an autosomal dominant or whether it is an autosomal recessive disorder? These are the charts of the autosomal disorders. How do you identify if it is autosomal dominant? How do you identify if it is autosomal recessive? So look here. If you observe the parents not having the disease, but if the children are having it, any of the children, parents not having it, children have it. See the next generation. Both parents are not affected, but one of the son is affected. both parents are not affected, but the son and the daughter are affected. So if you see in this generation, two offsprings were affected, but the parents didn't have the disease. If you see this generation, parents didn't have the disease, but offspring is affected. Such a disorder is a recessive disorder. See this. One of the parents had it, offsprings got it. One of the parents had it, offsprings got it. So if a parent has it and if the offspring gets it, it's a dominant disorder. Mind you, I am not discussing the details of the pedigree chart. I am just basically discussing, if you have an MCQ in front of you to identify a pedigree chart, what are you supposed to do? I am repeating the concept. First step is find out whether it is an autosomal disorder or whether it is a sex chromosomal disorder. What's the rule? If you don't see a pattern, if you don't see a pattern, if you don't see crisscross inheritance, that means it is autosomal. If you see crisscross inheritance, that means it is a sex chromosomal disorder. Crisscross inheritance means going from grandfather to grandson through the carrier female. So if you don't see a pattern, it is an autosomal disorder. Okay, now once you've identified it is an autosomal disorder, the next step would be whether to find out, whether to confirm whether it's autosomal dominant or autosomal recessive. So the trick is, if the parents don't suffer, but if the offsprings have the disease. See the next generation. Parents don't suffer, but the offspring has it. That means it's autosomal recessive. Parents have it, some of the offspring gets it. Parent has it, some of the offspring gets it. It's autosomal dominant. So this is a method by which you can easily identify a pedigree chart and mark your option accordingly. Use these methods and get your MCQs correct. Thank you.